Hey guys!
Hi guys!
Alright, so another reveal for the Funko SDCC exclusives. We are now at reveal 7, 8, and 9, and then a weird random one that just happened with one pop. Sort of strange. However, it continues to get good for us personally, and very expensive.
Yes, very, very expensive.
I don't think we have ever spent this, we're going to spend this much money.
I don't think so either.
In any, we've been through four now.
Mm-hmm, we've been through four.
Four SDCCs, and this is going to be very, very costly for us. Yeah. I think they're just doing more pops, though, than
normally. I think so, too. I feel like the lines have expanded so much, and I feel like we have more releases this year than we've ever had.
100% we definitely have. So it's going to be an expensive, expensive Comic-Con for a lot of us collectors. So let's get into Reveal 7.
Reveal 7 was Warner Brothers, and I know I squealed like a little child, and I'm sure a lot of people did.
We were at Chuck E. Cheese's.
Yes, we were!
When this happened, taking her niece there.
Yeah, and I was like, what? And I mean, you know, everybody in there is kind of loud anyway, so it doesn't really matter that I freaked out.
I just thought you won a game or something. No big deal.
So at first, Funko revealed Lincoln as Reaper from the 100. Now, this is limited to 750 pieces. We're also getting Dean with Baby from Supernatural. I know a lot of people are really excited for this one. We're also getting Lord of the Rings Aragorn and Arwen 2-pack. Harry Potter on his broom, or should I say the Nimbus 2000. Luna Lovegood with her Spectra Specs. And a 6-inch Akami from Fantastic Beast. I am so unbelievably excited for this.
I wonder which ones you are really, really wanting
back. I have to have Harry and Luna. I'm so glad we finally have Luna as a pop, especially with her Spectra Specs. Now let me go over the ones that we really like in this line and what we're really wanting. Now of course I have to have Luna, and I love that she's holding the Quibbler that came with the Spectra Specs, so that's kind of a fun little added in there. And of course I have to have Harry on his broom because that's such a cool design. And I have to also have Akami from Fantastic Beasts. I'm so excited for this. Like, what are you doing to me, Funko? You're trying to break the bank here.
They really are. So the Harry Potter's great.
Yes,
so
it is.
They're using a little clear plastic stand like Superman or some of the other ones that we've seen. That doesn't surprise me that they would do something like that.
Me
Not
either.
At all.
I mean, it makes sense.
Luna doesn't surprise me either because we know that they came out in Rock Candy and we were just waiting to see her come in pop form. And of course, that one's going to be popular.
Absolutely it is. I'm glad it's not limited to a specific number because I think a lot of people will be fighting for this one.
And the Akami?
Oh my God, so pretty!
The colors on that.
Yes.
Holy crap, that's unbelievable. And we wouldn't be taken serious if I didn't mention Dean with Baby.
Oh yeah, definitely.
This is one that people have been asking ever since we started collecting pops. Mm-hmm. Ever since Supernatural came out in pop form, they wanted this, and finally you get it!
Finally!
I'm sure, I would think that one would be a hot topic.
It has to be a hot topic. It would make sense.
So the only one that's going to be limited to the con is going to be the Lincoln. So everything else should end up in a store somewhere.
Now for the random reveal, I guess we'll say 7.5. Yeah. I don't really know. It's Twinkles in a Ghost Jar from Rick and Morty. So there you go. I guess that's kind of a little hidden surprise.
Now of course Funko does have the master license to make Rick and Morty toys. Like we saw the portal gun that they came out with. Wow, they're doing props
that's
now
so cool.
too. But what a cool pop.
Now day 8 was Disney. I know everybody has been waiting to see what they were going to do with the Disney line. And I felt like it really did deliver. Some things we kind of figured was going to happen and other things. I was like, ooh, that's cool. So up first, we're getting Chip and Dale 2-pack, which is flocked. We're also getting Winnie the Pooh, which is a bouncing Tigger, also flocked. Mr. Toad's Wild Bride, Mr. Toad, which is limited to 1,500 pieces. Moana, we're getting Hey Hey. Disneyland Resort Jolly Roger glow-in-the-dark version. Now, this is limited to 1,000 pieces. We're getting Darkwing Duck Negatron glow-in-the-dark. And we're also getting Aladdin and Abu on a magic carpet for a Dorbs ride. How flippin' cool is that? Now, some of the ones that we're both really excited for is the Flock Chip and Dale. I really want this one. I wanted Chip and Dale, but now that I can get it flocked, I'm pretty excited about that.
Yeah, so we know we've seen the Kingdom Hearts one. Yeah. This is the regular one. Chip and Dale's, I don't know, this is not Rescue Rangers, it's Chip and Dale, basically.
I guess so, yeah.
This is the one to have. Flocked, definitely. Everything. So, yeah, this is the one we'll be going after, no doubt.
I'm also excited to see a Flock Tigger. We have the original one, so this one, the design's a lot better. And I'm glad it's flocked.
I like how his face is sort of like weird.
Yeah, it's kind of cockeyed.
Really nice. And there's something about orange flock that looks really good. Yeah. I don't know. Now, one that I'm excited about is the Hey Hey.
Hey Hey.
Yeah, Hey Hey from Moana.
Hey Hey.
Hey Hey. So, Moana, honestly, in my opinion, is the best thing Disney's made in a long time.
Definitely. I love
it. I thought it was so
movie.
Good. It was an unbelievable movie. It really was. And, of course, these were the stupid chicken that
You're
runs
welcome.
Around with her. Yeah, you know, she always has to grab them out of the water.
I know. She's like, Hey Hey, no!
Yeah, yeah. So this is a good one to have, and I think we probably have to get this one too.
Oh, definitely.
It's rough, man. It's rough out here being a collector sometimes.
The one that I'm most excited about, I'm sure you're just as excited as I am, is Aladdin and Abu on the Magic Carpet. I have wanted a Magic Carpet ride, Pop Ride, Dorbs Ride. I don't care. I've wanted one for a while. And now that it's coming, I have to have this.
So I sort of do care. I would much rather have this in a Pop.
I would much rather have this in a Pop, but I'm finally getting
this.
But
we have Jasmine and Genie.
That's
true. Jafar and Pops. I think it's awesome they're doing it in a Dorbs Ride, but we want this in a Pop Ride. Make no mistake. And finally, reveal 9 was the miscellaneous reveal. This one's just full of a bunch of stuff. I don't know. This is where they're like, well, we don't really have anything for this or anything for that, so let's just put it all in a big group and hope people like it.
It's a hodgepodge.
So first off, we get Five Nights at Freddy's sister location, the Jump Scare Funtime Foxy. We're also getting from sister location, Jump Scare Baby. From Elder Scrolls, we get a 6-inch Dwarven Colossus. From Dr. Seuss, we get a Lorax that's flocked. From the Mighty Morphin Power Rangers, we get the 6-inch Megazord. Oh, yeah. From Masters of the Universe, we get a Scare Glow glow-in-the-dark. I think that one's really cool. We'll talk about that in a minute. Then, also from Masters of the Universe, we get Panthor with Battle Armor Skeletor. And Panthor is purple and flocked, which is really awesome.
Yes, it is.
Then, Rock Candy fans, you're also going to get a Masters of the Universe She-Ra. And finally, old school Funko fans will know this guy, Psycho Shriner. It was an original Funko design, and now it's coming to Pop form.
Mm-hmm. I really like his name. That's such a cool name.
So, a few of the outliers for me. First off, I do want to talk about the Five Nights at Freddy's ones. I don't care. We don't play the game. Nothing makes me want that. However, I do want to sort of comment, that is a great, awesome sculpt to do.
Oh, definitely.
So that's a jump scare from the game where they scare you and, you know, jump scares. Really cool way that they have the head opening up. So props to that. Now, the Dr. Seuss Lorax that's flocked. That's a really fun one. I know a lot
like
of people are
one.
Collecting the Dr. Seuss line. The flock seems to be the way to go to collect anything in Dr. Seuss,
absolutely,
right?
Absolutely, yeah.
I mean, there's something about flocked and Dr. Seuss that really goes together, I feel like.
I pretty much want everything flocked. I don't know what it is. I love the flocked variant.
Flocked's awesome.
Yeah,
old Christmas, man.
That's right.
And then, of course, you know I'm going to talk about the Megazord, the 6-inch Megazord. I actually already have this one on pre-order, thankfully. Now, hopefully it'll stay. Now, I've seen leaks that this one might end up in FYE. So if it does, I'll probably buy another one just in case my order gets canceled online. Because I got to have I gotta have it, Ashley. I'm not playing around.
Well,
Funko, I'm not playing around. I gotta have the Megazord.
Him, Funko.
And when the Dragonzord comes out, I gotta have that too.
Well, plus, you know, Comic-Con is notorious for orders getting canceled and issues like that. So if we can find it in store, we've gotta go ahead and pick it up.
Funko gods. Megazord.
Funko gods, be with us.
Yes. Now, the glow-in-the-dark Scare Glow from Masters of the Universe. I really like this one.
I do, too.
A lot of people like Skeletor. You know, they've been collecting Skeletor, and he's a little hard to find now, where this one takes it above and beyond. I really think this is awesome, including the Panthor with battle armor and Skeletor.
I love the Panthor one.
Purple velvet-looking stuff. Boy, man, we are taking it back, man, to the
70s. I know.
I feel like he should have a rug underneath it. It's like tiger stripe, like white and black tiger stripe or something. Yeah, I don't know, but that one's really cool. And then finally, the Psycho Shriner. That is just cool because it's an old school Pop. Now, I assume Psycho Shriner, Psycho. I think that's what I'm bringing that together. But yeah, cool. You're getting some old Funko. So if you've been around for a long time, you know that character. And yeah, he's coming to Pop form. So that was the three waves this week, 7, 8, and 9 in a random one, I guess, a miscellaneous one. It keeps getting worse for us.
Or does it keep getting better?
Yeah, it's getting worse in the Walla, I'm telling you. They've been doing really well this year. I want to say that they've really sort of touched on a lot of different licenses. Now, one they haven't touched on yet that they didn't last year, really, and the year before, horror.
Yeah.
Horror.
We usually get like one Pop out of the entire release.
Yeah, I want some crazy stuff out there. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I want Puppet Master. You know, I want some Puppet Master. That'd be amazing. But yeah, I just want to see more horror. And I've seen a lot of people sort of complain about all these that have coming out, and it's hard for people to collect them all. I don't have a problem with that, honestly. If they're making more, so much more, that you can't afford all the ones that they're bringing out, that's just how it goes, man.
I know. Unfortunately, that is the way of Comic-Con. We all know it's going to hurt our wallets, and we have to try to prepare for
it. We're just going to have to make the decision. People got a budget this Comic-Con. You got to decide, okay, How many can I buy? Say you're going to say, okay, I can buy 10. I'm going to spend $150 probably or more. You got to pick the 10 that you want bad.
Yeah,
you just got to do it.
Weigh the cost versus the need or the want.
You also got to think about what stores are going to sell them. So if it's like GameStop, chances are you might be able to get it later. We've seen
sometimes,
in the past that GameStop's exclusives stick around for a little while.
Mm-hmm.
Barnes & Noble's, they sort of stick around, although the website is awful during Comic-Con. And also, we've seen a lot of people ask, you know, when are these coming out? Are stores going to get them? Blah, blah, blah. We're going to have a video again, just like we have the past 3 years, how to get these popped. So we're going to find out what stores will be selling these, like a day or two before, probably, and we'll do a video. What stores get them? We'll give you the list, and we'll talk about how to get them, what to do. Had a game plan, basically.
Definitely. And another thing, Hot Topic usually gets quite a few of theirs. I mean, certain ones,
restocks,
certain characters.
Too.
Right. Certain characters they don't get a whole lot of, but for the most part, they get quite a few.
Yeah, and they'll restock them throughout the month or whatever. But, you know, some of the other stores, you got to think, okay, this is, I got to get like Toy Tokyo, which I've heard Toy Tokyo might not be selling them. They're going to only give them to the people that missed out last year when they had to cancel a bunch of them for New York Comic Con.
Well, that would make sense.
So, yeah. So, that's going to be interesting. I don't know. Good luck, guys. We're all going to find out
soon.
So, all right. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you next week.
Thanks, guys.
Bye.